cirrhosis watching Metal Massacre Productions.
How did you guys come up with the band Name Neurosis and who was behind the idea?
Dave thought of it first. It was a song in our, it was like the last song we wrote in our previous band that me and Dave and Jason had. It was called Neurosis. And we were throwing names around. We just thought that it was, it just kind of fit everyone. Would relate to that on some, would relate to that on some level within their experience. It certainly fit us. So, but I mean, we were children. We had the bands. As you know, we got lucky. Could have really, really done something pretty bad at that point. Wouldn't know.
Cool. You recently released your new album on a Found in Decay, which is also in Venice as well. How did you find the process overall, and how does this album compare to your previous ones?
Recording for us is pretty natural at this point. I mean, we've been recording with Steve Albini since 1999, and it's just a natural, organic process of setting up our equipment in a really nice sounding room with a really wonderful and experienced engineer. It's low pressure. We just basically set up and play like we do in the rehearsal studio, and it gets captured in the best analog, most hi-fi way possible, and it's really quite painless and easy working with him. It's done like all of our favorite albums were done in the 70s. You just set up and play, and you record it, you know, and there's no tricks, there's no gimmicks, there's no fixing it later, and it's the only way you can get a record done in a week, you know, doing it that way.
Because you guys are on your own record label as well, and you seem to have the creative freedom to do whatever you want, basically.
Absolutely.
A set meaning as a band. When we chose the title, we thought it was evocative on a lot of different levels, and people could take it and run with it as they please. And even the way we've talked about it amongst ourselves, there's different ways to look at it. But the way that I've liked to look at it for myself is that decay being the natural state of all things, when human relationships, whether they be personal or community-wide or society-wide or economies, whenever they end up in a state of decay, you end up also in a state of crisis. And it's during those times that where things are tough and things are difficult and things are hard on people, where people show their true colors and you find out who's true and who the honorable people that you stand with are, and who are the opportunists who take advantage of the situation. Basically, just that adversity shows people's true colors, and that we choose to surround ourselves with people who mean what they say.
Okay, that's really interesting. How have you found the tour so far?
You mean last night?
Any show.
We're just flying in for the weekend and going home. Yeah.
Yeah, it was last night was good. Necessarily there to see us. It was just the, you know, ATP weekend thing. So, you know, it's always cool to get to play to people who are unaware of what we've done or who we are. I always like that kind of energy, whatever, like that, you know. But I look forward to tonight quite a bit. I mean, playing with Godflesh is it's a long time coming. I mean, something that should have been done many years ago, but just never did, and so now we get the chance to do it and do it here.
Yeah.
You know, which is probably exactly where it should be.
It's been together for 27 years, which is really cool. What elements have you enjoyed the most during this time?
I'm not sure I understand what you mean by elements.
Like, what kind of highs and lows?
ours, you know, we traveled kind of outside of the rural experience, and that's how we grew up. You know, it was having just a different way of seeing the world, I think, and being able to make this really intense music, which basically, I think, saves our lives over and over again by giving us an outlet to express this stuff. It's all of it, the friendship, the brotherhood, the experience, the music, travel. It's a very privileged thing to be a part of.
Absolutely.
You can't imagine life without it.
Yeah, I mean, it definitely is. It's definitely a gift, you know. There's no other way to look at it. There's no way to really understand why or how, you know, if we were lucky enough to get this path. I wanted it, you know. We worked hard for it. That's without a doubt, but at the same time, a lot of people want it and work hard for it and don't necessarily get it. So we're very thankful and humble about the opportunity to do what we do.
Okay. Which band has been your favorite to tour with and why? You can take off flesh if you like.
Well, we haven't actually toured with them before. It's our first show with them. We love those guys. They're great guys. Totally looking forward to doing this together. You know, I think that, God, I don't know, man, there's been a few that we really got along good with on the road over the years. Back when we were just touring the States constantly, before we really got here or to Europe, after we were always out with this band Buzz of them that some people may know and most people won't because they've kind of gone away after a while. I think we did more shows with them than probably any band ever. And at one point we were really tearing clubs up, kind of just in our own little world. You know, there just wasn't a whole lot of other bands that were doing anything close to what the two of us were doing. Yeah, I gotta say, when we supported Pantera for 6 months, it was a pretty great experience as well. They treated us well, very nice guys to us, treated us with a lot of respect. That was an interesting opportunity and situation that we've always just kind of headlined our own shows and whatever size venue we were accommodated to. Going out with them was kind of a different deal because it was their show and we just would open it up. Pressure and an airplane sized PA system. Without a visual artist in 20 years. it's a, you know, it's interesting. We'll see what it brings us. You know, I think that we, between us and Josh, we just kind of all felt like it was time to do something different.
Somebody was looking for something.